Our next guest today is Janet Marlow, an internationally known for her contribution to the understanding of pet hearing sensitivities and how this affects their behavior. Janet's relaxation music for pets has proven success at putting animals at ease acoustically and scientifically. She appears on Animal Planet, CNN, Martha Stewart, and The Today Show. Barnes & Noble features her book, her box kit, Zendog, Music and Massage for a Stress-Free Pet. Entrepreneur magazine named Janet Marlow, CEO of Pet Acoustics, top 100 companies for brilliant ideas. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm glad to introduce to you Janet Marlow.
David, thank you, New York City. The title of this talk is called Urban Noises and Peaceful Pets, or Dogs and Cats Hear Much, Much More. So I'm going to start off with you with a chart and give you a very clear understanding of just how sensitive our pets are to sound. Now, you know, you've all been walking around here and the decibel level is very high. Thank you. He agrees. Over here on the far left, this is the chart of the Hertz level. That means frequencies. Frequencies are cycles per second. So on the left, a human range is up to 23,000 Hertz. We go from 20 to 23,000 Hertz. A horse can hear up to 33,500 Hertz. And dogs hear up to 45,000 Hertz. They hear twice as much as we do. Cats hear up to 64,000 Hertz. That's three times the hearing of a human. So I want you to understand that dogs and cats that are far below the human and horse range, that's their world, that's their hearing, that's their alert response level. In nature, they need that level of hearing because that will help them have survival in nature. They know which sounds to run away from, and they can hear incredible distances and volume. So keep that chart in mind, because this is what really is the basis of understanding our pets. So decibel is like volume in music. Frequencies is pitch. And sound waves is in rhythm in music. This is what makes sound in the air. Your pets have strong reactions to sounds in your home, like thunderstorms, separation anxiety, knocks on the door, excessive barking, cats hiding underneath furniture. This is all because sound is the most ongoing sense for animals. In other words, in your home, a dog or a cat, they know where everything is. They know where the cookie jar is. They know where all the smells are. But in the home, their hearing can't be fixed because it's an ongoing sense for them. You know that the word decibel comes from Alexander Graham Bell. He invented the machine that measures volume. And so volume is measured by decis, or 10 cycles per second, and thus the name decibel. So we credit Alexander Graham Bell. Quiet whisper in a library is 30 dB. Normal conversation, 60 to 70 dB. Now, in my research, I learned that between 60 and 80 dB is the most comfortable for a dog or a cat. So normal conversation and relationship to a dog or a cat, that's perfect. That's the way we are. That's how we talk. Now we get to telephone dial tone. 80 dBs. City traffic, 85 dBs. So now we're starting to get into the outdoor world of your dog or cat in New York City or in the suburbs. A train whistle or truck traffic is 90 dB. Examples of how important it is to understand the environment that you take your dog or your cat in. The shape of a dog's ear is significant to how sensitive they are to sound. Yorkie's ears, straight up. They are completely complete receptors to hounds that have long ears. That helps them keep the scent around their nose as they go. Nature is amazing. It makes all of the purposes of our dogs to have the same, the important shape of their ear to give them the important effect. Cats, straight up. Cats have ears that are straight up. Now, do you remember the chart that I showed you before? Cats hear how many more times than a human? 3 times more than a human. Dog hears twice as much as a human. Dogs hear 67 hertz to 45,000 hertz. Cats hear below, they can hear lower sounds than dogs and higher sounds than dogs. So how many of you have dogs and cats in the same household? Issues with dogs and cats getting along? Issues? Very often, dogs and cats will hear frequencies together and it will trigger behavior that you will not hear. Remember to tell you that they live in a world that we don't hear at all as human beings, and how important it is to be aware of their environment. Here's some common issues due to acute hearing sensitivities. How many of you have dogs that run away from the vacuum? Do you know why that is? Excessive vibration and high frequencies whirring from the machine of the vacuum cleaner. Well, the cat will have run away already before when you went to the doorknob of where the vacuum is. But then once you get to your dog, just tell him, move him into another area, or just say, I'm getting the vacuum cleaner, and he will know to move ahead. Thunderstorm nerves, anxieties from thunderstorm, because the power of a thunderstorm is 150 dB from a thunderclap. Now, their comfort level is from 60 to 80 dB. Now we're going up over twice as much. And so that is such a powerful experience for them in their bodies, as well as in their ears. And that causes extreme anxiety. Separation anxiety behaviors. Any dogs, cats with separation anxiety behaviors? You get the whole thing going, don't you? We will talk together after this. The seriousness of separation anxiety. The emotion of sound is very deep for an animal when they're left alone. Because again, sound and hearing is ongoing for them. They don't know what to expect. It could be the knock on the door, it could be the plane, it could be the thunderstorm, it could be the UPS truck coming up. You can't guarantee what's going on in your home when you're not there is going to be calming for your animal and making them feel balanced. The most important thing for an animal in nature is balance. You know how in the 1950s they said, fight or flee? Everything was fight or flee. It was so poetic to hear it. Fight, flee, flee, fight. But do animals just live from fight to flee? No. Their whole life is rest, balance. And so that's why it's so important for you to acknowledge all of their senses to help them feel balance in our life. Territorial aggression and excessive barking. Do any of you have issues? Excessive barking comes from triggers of behavior. There we go. Thank you. Right on cue. Not good for the animal. It's a very high stress experience for a dog to keep barking without them being able to gauge their own behavior. The first step to helping your animals feel calm in their environment is for you to learn how to hear like your pet, their ears, to see what it is that they're reacting to. If you can begin to do that, you will be on an amazing journey of engagement with your pet to understand them on a more complex level. That we can't control or feed or cover is their ears. Addressing all of their 5 senses within the environment is the key to their balance and well-being. So hearing acuteness is a good thing. This is what animals do. They hear acutely. It helps them to survive in nature. In your home, you'll be reactive to sound, but they can't flee from the sound. What they will do is that they will find a hiding spot, or they will cower in their place, or they will just be a little extra nervous if they hear something. So basically, you need to trust your pet. As soon as you get something reactive from them on a hearing level, know that they are hearing something that you are not hearing. Are you all with me so far? It's so logical and very simple, but it's something that until somebody points out all of these natural aspects of a dog or a cat, it's like you don't think about it, but I'm sure you will walk away from here saying, oh, it makes perfect sense to me now. So stress behaviors can be caused by this acute hearing sense, and by understanding the source, you can also resolve it. Have their environment to elicit calm and rest from them. Because remember, fight, small part of their lives. Flee, where they're going to go in your home. Rest, balance is what really our animals are looking for. My specialty is the research that I've done over the last decade on what the hearing frequencies are of a dog and a cat. And because I've been a recording artist and a concert performer for most of my life for humans, I've learned the value of music. I actually know from neuroscience that every cell in our body can be moved by vibration and frequency and sound. So for music for dogs and cats is an amazing experience. It's profound for them because it balances the air in their environment. We're very conscious about what's in front of us, but if we actually understand the air around us, we can understand behavior. You know, sometimes you get a little agitated, but you don't know why. Very often, there are frequencies and vibrations that go through the air that affect us, and we don't even know it. For animals, it's twice as much, three times as much. I have a CD series called Relaxation Music for Pets. I have the frequency range that is their alert response level. I take it out of the music so that they are not hearing any frequencies that are going to put them immediately into an alert or tense up their body or stress them out. And because those frequencies are not in the air, you know what they do? They find balance. They rest. Such an important part of a dog's life and your relationship with him or her is because it relieves stress. And not only relieves stress, but it relieves stress for you as well. So take a half an hour once a week and put on some music, turn your cell phone off, and your dog will so appreciate this. So what I'd like you to do is we're going to, first of all, always keep one hand on the dog. Because as soon as you release your hands, the dog will think the session is over and walk away. So massage techniques is different than petting and loving and kissing and hugging and squeezing the dog, which I love to do at home. So we're going to start with taking your hand. I'm going to learn it's called compression. You're just going to start from the head and just let the weight of your hand follow down a little bit down the neck. So you do that too. I'm going to talk you through it so you can do it yourself. That's it. Excellent, excellent. Just very, a little bit of compression. That means a little bit. And you never want to find, you don't want to put any pressure on any bony points onto your back. Now, dogs' necks have the most muscle tension of any part of their body. So what I'd like you to do is take one hand, and you're going to go in a circular motion with your fingertips around the neck. And they will love this, because this releases so much tension from their neck. Especially if you don't use a halter, and you're using a neck collar, and they're getting this way and that way. So, nice, very soft pad of the finger, no nails. Can you sense that the tension in this room has calmed down? Nice. Nice. This pet massage is different than petting. because they know right away that your intention through your hand, the energy through your hand, is giving them something therapeutic. So now what I'd like you to do is in a circular motion, go to the right of their spine, a little bit down, go to the right of their spine and feel all the muscles. Very good motion, very soft way with your hand. And then go on the other side, always keep one hand on your thigh, on the other side, go down. Go down their spine slightly because they're on your back. Is this feeling calm for you as well? Yeah, so it's feeling calm for you. That's great. One other thing is called petrissage, which is you want to take one of their legs, either front or back, and just gently squeeze all the way down. They love this. All the way down. You want to have flow, you want to have rhythm. Very gently down. That's it. They just love this. Just love this. So, and if they roll over and they want a belly rub, say, that's for later. Because belly rub is just a play experience for them. One of the things that they love is the ears. Now, some dogs are very sensitive. But you can take your hand and just gently cup your hand. It's another technique. And just pull back gently and be very rhythmic. Lots of flow. Very rhythmic. Very rhythmic. Take it through their ears. That's it. That's it. Good try. Very good. Excellent. You guys are great. Wonderful instincts. That's good. And then one of the things they like is the shake. You can kind of finish off the massage session with a little shake. You just go back. Go like this, all the way down their bodies, all the way down their bodies, all the way down their bodies. They're so good, these doggies. And then you can finish it off by some broad strokes. Just finish it off like as if you were doing this. A little energy work on the outside of their bodies. They feel that so much. Thank you, ladies, so much. Thank you, and all of these beautiful doggies. Look how wonderful they were. Give them a hand. If you are an off-leash dog walker, make sure that your dog is keying into your tone of voice all the time so that he knows at any given time you go, whatever sound it is that you make that you and your dog have come to an agreement with, that that's the code. Make sure that you have that dog in response to you so that the dog doesn't get out of control. Bring soothing music to the vet. How many dogs like to go to a vet? Not too many. So that nervousness, that stress, the hearing, the strangeness of the environment. You bring some music on an iPod, use my music or any music, it is very, very helpful to them. Music is a profound experience for a dog or cat because their whole world is volume, tone, and frequencies.